see hunters. Now, the game has a type system. So when hunters appear, they have to be assigned a type. In the actual game, they'll be clip-on basis, but these hunters are arcane, so... What that means is that each monster has a type. You look on your dashboard, there's a colour and a type. So you're mythic, you're undead. You are arcane, so these are the guys who are after you, and you're cursed. If you ever come across an enemy that's the same type as you, they do extra damage.
Okay.
And you are their top target.
Nothing new for me, yeah?
Okay. Hunters always have a type, or is that just...
So they always get assigned a type. Yeah. Peasants are just nothing, and town heroes have a predefined type. So these, this is an undead town hero, there's a bounty hunter that's cursed. So, who wants to go first?
Me.
He always does.
We'll give you the treasured first player token. To play your turn, it's very simple. You roll these six dice, and then that's your pool to spend from. So there's six symbols you can get. There's the villager activation, so what that means is that one villager in the zone furthest away from the castle arc moves up. There's melee, which means you can deal 1 point of damage in your zone. There's range, which means you can deal 1 point of damage in an adjacent zone. Magic is used to spend on various abilities. There's also two other symbols that are used for defense. There is that one and that one. That's defense, that's retaliation. So defense, you block a hit. Retaliation, you take the damage, but you deal equal damage back. And to spend your dice, you put them in the various slots in your dashboard. You can use anything for movement. So for instance, in this row, I could say, well, I'm going to move with that. One dice equals one zone for movement. And that is it. So,
You can do minimum one. You can move.
You can do minimum one, yeah.
You can't reroll.
Take an action.
Certain things on it.
Take an action to be
one. Oh, yes, I'm doing that. There are instances, if you get three of the same result, you can reroll those three.
So that one, does that mean they...
So we resolve those straight away. Right. So that's a village activation. So the furthest away zone from the castle and heart. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3 is this zone. Just move one village away.
Okay. So these are magic.
These are retaliation, so defense.
Yeah, okay.
And their defense as well. They could be spent in your defense slots. So you're quite a defensive character. You've got three slots, whereas you've only got one.
So if I put them there for later, or they're just for
they're
this
there
round?
For this round. So if you get attacked during this round, you will block some of the hits.
So you take these and put them there instead?
That's
yeah.
it, yeah. And you can also reserve dice rolls in a reserve slot, and you can hold them to them indefinitely. It means you roll less dice, but you've got a guaranteed result.
But everyone else will roll one.
So
if I say put these here,
yep.
So I've got them stacked up and then put one of those there so they can hit me, I'll defend it and then hit them back. And then I could save that to hit them.
You could do, but you probably want to move up and start to get into combat or something.
Right. So I'll just move there then, shall I?
Yeah, so you need to spend one of your die to move there.
So I'll use that one. So I'll use those two there, so they're gone. Probably have done this at the end, but there you go. So that's movement. I don't really want to go off on my own, do I? Or is that?
You're quite powerful. If you die in this game, you just respawn in the castle heart. Yeah. The castle heart takes damage. If the castle heart ever reaches zero, it's game over.
Is that your health?
Yes, that's your health. So if you take
so
up the damage, sorry, you should. You're quite a tanky character. That's your experience. So once you get enough experience points equal to that, you level up and you can choose.
Oh, okay,
ability.
Right.
So these are not available just yet.
No, so everyone starts with one ability, it's level one of that, and each ability has two levels.
Okay.
Oh, okay, so that upgrades that, is it? Once you level up, right?
Alright, I'm done.
Okay, so you're done. So then you just pass dice clockwise.
Okay. So, they go the furthest from here, or the furthest from us, if they activate?
Furthest from here. So this is the most important place in the castle. So you've got
two of them activate now, and they'll move into there.
So you've got two villager symbols, so they activate first, so move two villagers up.
Okay.
Now you don't really have to worry about defence just yet because you're quite far away. These are zero range, these are one. So
how come this guy doesn't move?
So we always move the furthest away from the castle heart. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4.
Right.
That's
so they keep together. Right.
They don't run off on their own.
Now the castle heart. Yeah. So your first ability is called Sol Arrow. It means your first range attack can target any zone in the castle. So you have to spend one magic to use it, and then one range attack to kill someone. So you could target any zone if you wanted to.
Okay. I bet had. So it's not like this, or
it's completely
and how big an attack is that?
So that's 1 point of damage. Hunters and peasants have 1 point of have one health, and then town heroes they have all their special stats. They have
one of these.
Yeah, sure.
I was thinking one of those.
One of those.
They're your type, so it's a good idea to get
ready.
Because they deal 2 damage to you per attack, so these potentially would deal 8 damage, so they could kill you essentially in one.
Yeah.
So you kill one of them, you get 1 XP for that.
I like how it's like, they're your type, get rid of them.
It's not the way it normally goes.
Okay. So you might as well stick on a shield.
Or you could
move up.
I don't have you this yet.
I'm sure to get you.
You can't attack, so you might as well use that to move.
Attack to move?
Yeah.
So beautiful.
So you stick that on your movement. Gorgeous.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This guy. Stick. Oh, it's broken.
Go and stick.
Okay.
And then you've got one left and you can't actually use it, so you might as well. Well,
you don't have to spend your dice results, you can just leave them.
But there's no point not stacking that on the fence, right?
Yeah.
I assume you. So that's good. Just one left guy.
How long do your defence symbol stay there for? Is that for the round or what?
Is that until I get hit or until...
No, they clear at the end of the round. So
clear each round.
The end of our round or until...
The end of the whole... So this is the monster phase, then there's a villain phase, then there's clean up, in which case
Okay. So
you could have put it in reserve, and then you could have kept it next time.
Yeah, but I'd roll one left guy.
Yeah.
Ah, I see. So I could get this one in reserve there.
You can do it, and you just roll one less die on the next
one. But you do get a guaranteed result.
Why not?
You might better hold the attack.
Two villages.
What does unlucky do?
So unlucky, when you cast it on a zone, all attacks in that zone have a 50-50 chance of being successful. So every attack you flip the coin, there's actually a nice coin in the game, it's not this 10p you keep asking. And that includes monsters as well. So any attack in that zone.
I can't do any magic yet.
You haven't got those yet, right?
So that's useless to me.
We'll use that for moving. You're letting fate decide if they die.
So I think I might as well move twice and come up and join Kez.
Which one are you?
I'll keep that one. And that's when I get hit, I hit back, is it?
That's it, yeah.
But so it doesn't defend me at all?
It just retaliates. So down heroes do quite a lot of damage, but you do equal damage back to them. So it's a bit of a risky strategy.
Right,
But that has to be in the defence slot to be active. In reserve, you're just holding on to it for when you want to
move. Yeah.
She's not expecting to get attacked yet. If he's moving here...
These guys are going to move next time. In a village phase,
all villagers attack and move in that specific order.
Oh,
right.
So they won't actually attack us, they'll just move into us, they'll attack nothing and then move in here.
Yes, but if they were hunters, they would attack because hunters have long range.
Right. But if he rolls some villager torches, then we'll get some in here.
But they won't attack us.
They'll attack in the villager phase.
Yes.
Right, okay.
So it would be good to reserve a few in defence.
But I can only put defence dice here.
So do they attack? Do we choose?
I don't have any.
So the targeting priorities, they're always attacking the nemesis first, which is a monster of the same type. The castle heart, if that's an option. Then monsters. If there's multiple monsters,
can I nominate
2 people.
I'm not sure it is difficult.
Does
that make a difference?
So if I want to spend this, so that if they attack me, I hit them back, where do I put it?
You put it in defence, yeah. So you just put a symbol to represent.
So you can only put that or that in these slots.
Yeah.
Okay, got you. And I won't bother preserving that because I haven't got any magic.
Okay.
Right.
Right, magic is an additional cost for to use this.
Yeah, so you'd spend one magic symbol to activate that ability.
Can I use this?
If you want to, yeah.
Ooh, wow.
Oh, I see.
That's creepy. It's very fitting.
What's creepy about it?
So that's attacking.
Okay.
That has to be in the same zone. Right. So you can get 1, 2, 3 and then slash the hell out of them. Can you remind me what that is again?
So that's a ranged attack, so that is 1 point of damage to an adjacent zone.
Oh, that's a good shell, isn't it? And then that's the magic.
Yep.
So, if I want to make them unlucky, can you explain that?
Yeah, so that's the range of the ability.
Right.
So you have to be within 0 and 1, you have to have line of sight. So line of sight runs parallel with the board. If that zone becomes unlucky, when it's the villager phase, when they attack, for every villager attacking, you flip the coin, and if it's a tails, the attack will fail.
Okay.
If they have a tail.
So you want to make this one unlucky?
At the moment, none of those villages are posing a threat to you. They're too far away, so you don't really need to. You could reserve the magic symbol so you can cast that ability whenever you want to.
Right. It's only really useful for range attacks on us, right? From Because you, otherwise it's going to cost us. Yeah. If you move to here, you can range attack.
Yeah, that's your range. Yeah. So I can use 2-2 moves.
Yeah.
And then.
What range attacks?
I don't.
They don't have a zone to go in.
I don't have a zone to put them in.
You just put them on character portrait shadow as well.
Attack twice.
Okay, so it's two villages.
How about this?
And you get 2 HP for that.
I want to kill something. I didn't like that first village earlier now.
Where am I? Up here. Can I then move back?
Yeah. So stay with us.
Chicken.
Not chicken, tactics.
So the action is, these guys.
Right, so that's the end of the monster phase. Now it's the villager phase. So what happens is, there's a village event wheel here. That is advanced 1 point for every person playing, so it's 4. So it goes. 1, 2, 3, 4. In each scenario, it'll tell you when village events trigger. So village events trigger on 5 in this particular scenario. We haven't got to that point yet, so we're okay. Now all villagers would attack and move. So these have no targets, so they just move. These also don't have a target, they move up. If any traps are on board, then they trigger. There's not. And then now we respawn for each zone. So here.
Where's this trap?
Where is that trap? That's a trap that you can purchase.
Okay.
So you can place it in the castle.
No way! So
we've got 5 peasants. We're going to spawn. 1, 2, 3, 4.
How much is it?
5. The cost is at the top. It's 1 magic symbol to purchase.
You could afford it.
And there.
I think that had to be in the castle.
Can you? We've got two hunters.
Sorry. And those hunters.
To be in the castle to pay for this.
Yeah, it goes down in the exact zone you're in.
He could have bought that last turn.
And they're cursed hunters. Yeah.
Who's cursed?
Sorry,
number
3.
Me? Is that
me? So many questions, cursed.
Oh, I'm saying that. This is cursed. So these guys are good at shooting live.
What can I do?
Okay.
What are they wearing? What's their favourite colour?
Kill them for me.
Right, so then that's the end of the villager phase. So now we deal a new trap. So that's swinging blade. So on the trap, it tells you where it can be placed and who it affects. That can be placed in corridors, it affects peasants and hunters. That does 3 damage, and any hunters are left to stun.
He mentioned quite a good question. When I was in that zone, I just reserved that.
Yep.
But I could have purchased that before.
You can't place traps in the castle heart, but you could have placed it there if you wanted to.
Can we go?
Oh, that was an option.
Can we fall on them traps?
No, so traps, because you know where they are, they don't hurt you.
Yeah, I think we should have done that.
Okay, so now we've got a new first
can
player.
We say that we did that?
Well, you'll be fine, don't worry.
So
all of your defence clears if you've got any to the end of the round.
Oh.
And it's a new turn, so now it's you and you roll. These guys moved already. So you roll 1 less because you've got a reserve.
Yeah. Oh, you want to roll 1 less.
No one's moving. I've got ranged attack. For no thingy.
Shoot these guys.
We're close enough anyway, aren't
we? Yeah, you don't need the ability now. Shoot.
Right.
15 minutes on auction.
Okay.
Yep, that one.
How far in heaven range?
Thank you very much, guys.